It's Bonfon again in Formula E in the last race of the third season. And we would like to know especially about DS. How much things learn DS from these two seasons that made in the championship?
Formula E is an amazing experience for us. I personally believe that Formula E is really the discipline of the future. That's why we decided to start almost from the first season, which actually joined in season two. And since then, it's been an amazing ride in terms of technology development. In fact, the technology we develop here for the track are going to be available on DS7 Crossback on the plug-in hybrid version within 18 months from now. So this is really a great opportunity for us to raise the technological know-how of DS and to make it available for our customers.
And the most interesting thing is that the technology is passed from the races to the street in few time.
Yes, it goes very fast from the race to the street because we can transfer software. In fact, those cars are extremely technological. Of course, the battery is important. Of course, the powertrain is extremely important. But the most important thing to win the race is the software strategy that we are using to manage the energy, to have the car as energy efficient as possible. And these software algorithms that are being developed for the competition, we can use them directly in the street for the customers. It's not the case usually with the hardware of the competition because the cost obviously is too high for the normal cars. But with software, you can do it. And so you can transfer the technology directly from the track to the street.
You are the CIO of DS Automobiles, and so you have under your vision all world market. Speaking about Italy, how can it be important for the Italian market to have the Rome race next season and to be, of course, with DS Virgin Racing in the first line?
The Formula E is really becoming something huge. We were early believers in this formula. We joined almost at the beginning, and now we see that all the car manufacturers are coming to the season. All the big premium Germans have joined. The latest announced is Porsche, now joining the championship as well. So I think this is the discipline of the 21st century. And we are very proud at DS to have made this decision very early on in a forward-looking. You know, the signature of the brand is a spirit of avant-garde, so we kind of stay true to this signature by making the choice of doing Formula E. And I think it will be very good that Italy gets its own race. It's becoming a very exciting thing for people in the big cities. The fact that the tracks are in the center of the cities, I think makes it very exciting for people. They can come, be along the track. It's a way for us as brands to go and meet our customers. So I'm very excited that we can maybe race in Italy pretty soon.
And other thing, you anticipate my next question, was what do you think about the new manufacturers, Mercedes and Porsche, at least that are entering Formula E, and how is exciting for DS to fight with them?
You know, when you are an early believer in something and you start to show the way, and then you see big companies like Mercedes, like Porsche joining you, I think it is an exciting moment. It shows that we are ahead of the curve. We are playing a key role in the industry, bringing new technology. And we see that this is going to help the championship to become even more important, more followed. It's going to raise, obviously, the audience of the championship. So it's a very exciting future for the Formula E.
Thank you very much and good luck for the next two races of the season, and of course I hope to see you next season.
Thank you very much. After the double win in New York, which was really writing history because the Formula E in New York was the first ever automotive race within New York. We were happy enough to make a double win for this first edition in New York. So we're very excited to be here in Montreal. And let's see what happens.